Welcome, everyone. I'm so excited to tell you about this podcast. It's called The DK Project, but it's really The Darren Show. So thanks for tuning in. You're going to want to sit back, buckle up, and enjoy the ride.
Let's go! It's time to shine, boys.
Shakalaka.
Another episode of the DK Project is on its way.
Excellent.
What's happening? We got Dave here in the passenger seat. We got Big Easy wherever the hell he is. Nobody ever.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, how's it going?
Nobody ever knows.
Oh, I'm off the grid, buddy. I'm in the dark.
I like it. Evidently, yeah. You are, because your duo connection sucks.
Yeah, literally off the grid today. No, I don't know what happened there, but I'm glad we connected.
Yeah.
I'm glad I figured it out on my tech side where you couldn't in your studio.
So what? Whatever. No. I mean, yeah, it sounds like your IT department is a little sharper than mine. Although, what does that consist of? You hit the button, I didn't?
Yes, exactly.
Whatever. It's bullshit. It's the man trying to keep us down.
Hey, I'm just happy to be on this call. I've missed the last episode.
I know you missed the good ones, man.
It's good to have you
the
back.
Fire.
I hope all those listeners enjoy that amazing interview. That was good, man.
I'm telling you, the numbers are dialed. We are nothing short of awesome.
We should actually pump the brakes a little and slow this thing down.
Right?
The numbers are so high.
What?
The numbers are so high.
What? Yeah. No. I just heard, I just watched Tom and Christina's podcast, and they just got McDonald's as a sponsor. What sponsors have you brought to the show? Oh, that's right. None. That's all right.
Whoa.
That's all right.
Really?
Well, you're the
McDonald's?
One.
McDonald's?
Yeah, McDonald's. That's a big one, huh? Do you have to eat their crap then?
Well,
I mean, I don't mean crap. I mean, it's delicious. Well, actually, they were a sponsor. They got fired, and now McDonald's came back to him and said, hey, you know, maybe we want to take another look at this. So, yeah, whatever. They're doing it. Good for them. Good for them.
All right.
What's the latest, boys? Boy, I have been busy. I have been busy on adventures, just getting stuff for the show.
Oh,
and that's what
I do.
That's my new thing. That's my new thing. Dave, what have you been up to?
I have been busy trying to get a kid signed up for college, screwed up the transcripts.
Ah!
So then the whole school shut down for a week, so we had to kind of get some back channels and get the old transcripts set off in time.
So this brings up a good question. At what point do you say, hey, 18-year-old?
You handle it.
Handle this shit.
Exactly.
I think. Wait a minute. I just had deja vu. I think my dad said that to me.
Right.
That's probably why I didn't go.
Right. Huh. Well, this could be a parenting issue. Like, we should have planned this ahead and had him ready to take on responsibility.
Well, that's true. That's true.
Nothing like avoiding responsibility right before you go to college.
Right. Right.
Well, I think it's a big step. I think they're cold. I think they're nervous. You know, it's a big undertaking. And, you know, I don't know. Everybody I talk to, man, I tell them the kid's going to ASU, and you know what the first response is? Oh, party school.
Party school.
Is that what they say, really?
Oh, yeah.
I'm not in the college loop yet. My kids are a little too young, but, man, that's party schools are fun. That's where I'd go.
I told them, don't come home with an addiction you can't shake and no kids. Other than that, have fun, buddy.
Right. Knock yourself out.
I'm starting to see why they maybe aren't taking the responsibility, because I set such a high bar, huh?
by the time the third kid gets to college, be like, whatever. Come back with whatever. Don't.
Psst, you know what? You don't really have to go. Here's 20 cash. Let's call it even. So now what? Now I thought you were done. I thought he was in.
He was, but evidently you have to get senior year transcripts in.
Oh,
too.
Yeah. I think we
and
just
that's
sent
where
ours.
We dropped the ball on that.
Yeah, I don't know why you would say we, dude. It is not your fault.
I'd like to blame it on my wife, actually.
Why is it a parent's problem?
Well,
I mean, your kid's working, so that's a plus. Mine is not.
Yes.
My so you know, he's maybe busy at the JOB. That's cool. But still, this seems like stuff. I mean, God, I don't know.
No, it's kind of like putting it off, and then all of a sudden, okay, I got to do it.
Yeah.
And now the high school's closed where you got to get your transcripts.
It's like a phone call,
isn't
it? From
the 24th to the 1st. So they're closed all week. There's no one to call.
We have two kids.
I think you could do it online.
I'd be willing to bet you could go to the school portal and get anything you need.
I'll give you $100 cash right now if you can log into the portal.
Yeah, right.
I'm certain that's not happening.
Yeah, just go to the porthole.
Yeah,
this
no.
is fucking Star Trek or something.
I don't even know where there is no portal. Beam me up, Scotte. No, we're not buying that. Well, if that's your biggest problem, hey, you're doing well. You're doing well. I like it. Hey, listen to this. I had a hankering. I've always had a hankering, and I've never solved it. But the other day, I'm like, for some reason, I want Korean barbecue. I got to have it. So I threw it in the old Google machine and said, hey, Korean barbecue near me. So I so it says, hey, this joint, we'll call it whatever, Korean barbecue place. And there's one in Eden Prairie. I'm like, hey, we're going. So the wife and I load up the hoopty and we head over there to have a little Korean barbecue, which I've never had. Have you guys ever had?
I have, yeah.
Once. Yeah.
Like you're talking authentic Korean, like where the little wire thing over the flame.
Yeah, sure. I didn't go in the kitchen, dude. I sat in my booth where I belonged.
Oh, you didn't have a Korean barbecue then?
Like the out at the table type shit.
No, that's white trash. Japanese right there.
You had Chinese food with a Korean glaze on it.
They put
Korean junk on it.
Let me explain here. Let me walk you down the road of Korean barbecue. So right. I find this place, we drive by and we give it the old, ooh, there's not a lot of people in there. What do we do? So we're like, you know what? Let's try it. We're just going to go. I got to try these things. I need ammunition for my show, and I want to try some Korean barbecue. So we go in there, and what was the good sign that I saw? There's Korean people in there eating. That's a good sign. I mean, really. Yeah. Although there were people watching cartoons at the bar that seemed to be maybe in a management or an ownership position. It's a little weird. Okay, we're going to walk right by that. So we get in there, and I look at the wife, and we do a fair amount of real estate stuff. And I'm very keen nose to a mold wet smell.
Oh.
And I'm like, do you smell that? Like, are you having trouble breathing too? And she says, yeah, something's wrong here. I'm like, well, we're the seventh and eighth person in the building, so you can't exactly just walk out unnoticed. So I'm like, let's just suck it up. And all that, a lot of this one area had the chairs on top of the tables. And I'm like, oh, maybe they're closing. I don't know.
Or cleaning.
Maybe they had a water leak because there's no flooring. She goes, so the carpet got wet and they pulled the carpet out. So the server comes over and I go, hey, did you guys have a water leak? And he goes, no, why? I'm like, oh. I'm like, well, I just, you know, I thought maybe the last time I was here there was carpet or something. I can't remember. And he's like, well, and I said, and there's kind of a hue of mold and mildew in the air. And then I'm thinking, is this some kind of Korean barbecue smell that I'm not aware of? Like, is that what kimchi smells like? Or is
could
that,
be.
You know what I mean? So.
Oh, yeah, because it's new. Sure. Now you're questioning yourself.
Well, good God. So anyway, I'm like looking at the menu and it's like, what do you do? I don't even know. I don't even know what this is. So you have this sampler platter for $39.99. I'm like, dude, I'm all about sampler platter. Give me the sampler platter. He's like, so you have this, and this meat, and this meat, like all kinds of meat. So I'm like, yeah, do it, dude. I love the meat. And
I'm pro meat.
Yeah, well, the little picture on the Yelp deal looked solid, looked good, like what I wanted. And so he's like, you'll get these things and whatever. So and the bonus for to keep the bride happy, a solid bottle of wine for $10. If you order the sampler platter, because I think in the end, I figured out their motive was they're going to want you drunk to eat this shit because he comes out with this. Okay. Comes out with these four little plates. One had a little potato thing and one had, there were like four little mystery things. And he goes, these are unlimited refills. You can eat as much as you want. Well, you get a fat slob like me in there, man. That's a gold mine. And I'm looking at Dave here, and he's giving me the, Jesus Christ, it's a long story.
Well, no, I'm just wondering when you got to the Kung Pao chicken, because this ain't Korean.
I'm getting to the end. Oh, no, this was. It had like, there was like a kimchi plate, and there was like a potatoes were cold plate, and there was, and those weren't bad, right? Those weren't bad. So then he comes out with this, with pizza tray of meat. Literally. It looked like a Christmas wreath of meat on a tray. So my eyes light up right away. I'm like, I don't care if I can't breathe. I got this pizza coming at my face.
Oh, I'm getting hungry.
And he sets it down. And I think I would have rather shat in my mouth. It was like, what? Like the worst meat. Like you know when you're carving something up and you throw all that shitty meat away because no one's going to eat it?
Yeah.
I think these guys buy that.
That's where
I think that's where they get their meat from. And Monica goes, ooh, sauteed onions. And the guy goes, no, that's pork belly. I'm like, that's just pure fat, dude. That is not.
That's what pork belly is.
Oh, not at Darren's house. We're not eating that.
Well, that's exactly
I eat bacon, brother.
Pork belly is fat.
I know. So I push that off to the side. Well, then I start gnarling through this gristle because I'm like, we got to at least make it look like we tried. She's over there hitting that bottle of wine like there's no tomorrow.
Yeah. She's hitting the bottle of wine, Googling the next restaurant you're going
to
go to.
Well, this is my point. So I'm like, the guy comes over to check on us. I'm like, oh my gosh. I said, I'm so embarrassed. We couldn't finish it. Wow, that's a lot of food. Can I get a couple more of those little potato things? Those were kind of nice. and then he takes the tray away, and these people are starting to come in like families, a lot of them Korean. So I'm like, what the hell is going on?
They gave you the white man's plate?
I think they did. They had all the good meat for everybody else.
That's exactly right.
But I'm like, this is your sampler tray that you're giving people, and I'm boy, not a good idea. This was horrible.
Yeah.
Like really bad. So what I did is I hopped out of there and I went back to my standard. I got a new standard, right? I'm not on a new diet. I made a lifestyle change. Yeah. Boom. Boom. And that olives in Excelsior with the gluten-free Hawaiian pizza is money in the bank, baby. So we actually left a restaurant to go to another restaurant because
That's not a new move for you, though. I mean, to be fair.
Dude, you don't have to point that out.
Several times.
I'll mark that, edit that out. That ain't right. So actually, that's the most common thing that I run into people who want to talk about the show. And I'm not talking about people I know. I'm talking about like people I kind of know, and they know I do the show. And that's their first response. 5 restaurants in one day, dude? I'm like, yeah, that was a Saturday for me. No problem.
But, so you're not going back.
I not only am I not going back, I may have to call the health department.
Not even for the little potato things.
No, those were just to keep me alive till I could get a pizza. Because I was hungry. I am. Dude, you can't say the name on there. Are you kidding me?
No, it was not.
No, it was not. Yeah, I'm going to say it is 0 stars on the dog food chain.
All right.
That shit is bad.
No pun intended with the dog food.
Yeah, well.
There could have been some dog in there.
Did Fluffy have big, high, and juicy leg?
Oh, boy.
Boom. Yeah, it was a tough day. I can't even tell you. I was not happy. So I don't know. Maybe I need to give it another shot. I probably have to do it solo because the bride will not
I doubt it.
Go down that road again.
There's nothing worse than being excited to go eat someplace and having the food just fucking horrible.
Launch a deuce right on your plate, man. I hate that. It was so bad.
Or when your buddies tell you how good a place is and you got to eat here and you get there and it's like, I need new friends. Because this isn't working.
Hey, I got a follow-up to last week when we talked about, or maybe 2 weeks ago, when we talked about that burrito I got hiding under the old chair in my car.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I stopped at the local joint today to have a burrito, not Chipotle. It was a different establishment. It was Trade Winds. And she puts this thing together, and I always go like, hey, because they got this thick-cut, serious bacon, right? And I'm like, yeah, throw a piece of bacon on there. You know, it's like, oh, it's right there. Just flip her on there. So they always do. Well, today I saw the piece of bacon.
Wait. On a burrito?
Yeah, you know, it's kind of a collection of items.
It's an American burrito.
Yeah. The bacon's the only step out of the burrito world. And technically, if you do the pinto beans, there's bacon in there anyway. So we're just amplifying the bacon flavor.
Okay.
You could put bacon on dog shit, dude, and I'd eat it. I mean, I love... No,
I don't think I'd do bacon on a real, like a burrito.
No. It's an accoutrement. You eat a little side thing. You're eating your burrito, and you're like, oh, wait, I'll take a little bite of bacon. Mmm. Hey, anyway, so today...
It's like a fat man's mint.
I why do I want to yell out bingo right now? That is the truth, man. That's a home run. Hey, that is hilarious. So today I keep a pretty clean hoopty other than what hides under the seat. Speaking of which, the other day I bought one of these little protein snacks and it had three little compartments, and the one had cheese. And two of those little pieces of cheese fell under my seat. And I have ripped that car apart and I can't find them. So that's going to be a problem later.
That is going to be a mold situation.
Ah, it's just penicillin, baby. Hey, so anyway, I'm eating this burrito with a little bacon kicker. And I keep a pretty clean hoopty from the seats up. And the bacon she gave me today was fat. It was pork belly. It looked like something you didn't want to eat. You know, that rubberized bacon? It's not real.
Yeah.
So I like kind of pull it out of my burrito, and it's got like a little salsa on it, a little bit of whatever. And I'm like, I'm just going to launch it out the window because, what, you know, I mean, it's the birds are going to eat it. So I turn, flick it out the window. The window was up. So now I got bacon splatter all over my deal. God. I got a slag of bacon that didn't make it out.
And you can't just wipe that off. That's an oily mess.
Oh, man.
Did it stick?
No, it rolled down. So there's bacon juice all the way down my car door. I'm like, brutal.
Your shirt.
It wasn't
You're on
pleasant.
The way to a meeting.
Well, luckily I had the podcast t-shirt on, so... they're built to weather a little chow flying around. That was a special addition I had done to them. But so not a strong food week for me. Let me tell you, I've got a couple of fails. Oof, bad news. But I'm willing to give it another whirl.
You can't go wrong with Taco Bell.
Oh, Jesus, dude. Come on.
It's a 5-star Mexican restaurant.
Once you are over 14 years old.
No.
It is. No. You can eat there until you're 17.
Nope. 48 right here, baby.
You are crazy.
Once a week minimum.
Are you kidding me?
If I don't hit it once a week, my week sucks.
Oh, my God.
And I do 3 burrito supremes with the Dorito Locos taco.
Of course you do.
And a chili cheese burrito.
I think I think that might produce some gas.
Wait, Dave, let's go old school, Dave. Dave, I got a quiz.
Okay.
What did the chili cheese burrito used to be called?
Chilito.
Chilito. That's right. Yes.
Oh man.
That was Darren's fave.
I could tell you some stories, but my kids listen. And we digress. Yeah, I don't know, Dave. I'm thinking we're going to take away your restaurant credibility with the Taco Bell.
Yeah, you can't pipe in on the food.
Although, you know what? Maybe Taco Bell will sponsor us, and then I'll go there.
I'm telling you.
I've always been more of a Taco John's guy.
Negative.
Ooh, potato ole, 6-pack and a pound.
You know what? That is the starting only to see why I'm fucking so fat. Things people say about
I thought
Taco.
We were going with no F-bangers.
I know
today.
It. I've screwed up.
This
we're
is
have
not
to
radio ready.
We're gonna have to cut a couple of my apart.
Good.
I
God,
apologize,
Dave.
Radio Land. Let me start over. The only thing the darn people say about Taco John's.
Fuck that. You got to swear, dude. You can't say darn.
Darn just sounds lame. Yeah.
Is the potato
sounds
Olay's.
Like somebody goes to Taco
No one
Bell.
Ever says another damn thing about it. It's just potato Olay's this. Potato
Olay's
that.
Well, that's all
that.
You can eat there.
Right. There's a whole world available to you
no,
at Taco
dude,
Bell.
No, dude. That is dog crap. You
no,
cannot eat that stuff.
No, it's not. I even go over here to Jubilee and get the Taco Bell seasoning so when I make tacos at home, I can get close.
Wait, okay. Dave, I believe you'll have to Google this. I believe right. What?
Somebody's
believe,
running for the border.
I believe a while back I read an article that they had Taco Bell had some trouble because they weren't supposed to call their like beef burrito beef because there wasn't enough actual beef in it to be beef. There was so much filler in it.
Well, I'm okay. Well, see, I don't eat the beef burrito, so there we go. I eat the chili cheese burrito.
They serve it to me with a milk and an action figure.
You cannot help.
Come on, dude. Yeah, give me the number four kids meal. Yeah, I'll take the milk and a boy toy. I need a toy for a boy.
Dave's getting his Taco Bell and vaping over the corner.
Right. Come on.
Oh, it's the best fast food restaurant, you know, bar what? None.
I haven't had a solid night of drinking in like 4 years. Coming up on 4 years here in about a week.
Nice.
And I think that anniversary is celebrated with my last time I went to Taco Bell. I don't know that sober people go to Taco Bell once you're over 17 years old. Dave, what is going on?
Do you want to do a show right from the parking lot and I'll show you? I'll teach you.
No. I cannot.
Actually, you know what? Next week, Dave, just bring in a sack of your favorites from the restaurant and have Darren sample them and prove them wrong.
Done deal.
You know what? I only have so many candles and air freshener. I cannot combat Taco Bell stop.
He'll
do the rest of the show from the can.
my shit hair doesn't have a fan.
I'll add lettuce.
What?
To everything.
We'll make it all healthy and shit.
Yeah. Oh.
Whatever, dude. You have no restaurant credit going forward, period.
Oh, I certainly do.
That is horrible. Eric, when was the last time you were at a Taco Bell?
Oh, dude, 20 or under.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Those are
good times, though.
No, you just get old, and then you start living. You stop living. See, I'm still living.
That's living?
Well, yes.
I don't know.
Shoot. I'm just slumming it over at Olive's.
Right. Although, what am I bitching about? The meat over at Goji Boys is probably worse than what they're serving at Taco Bell.
Hazelwood, Taco Bell. I'm going to Taco Bell.
Based on your description,
you are out of your mind. I think the difference between Taco Bell and Goji Brothers is Goji serves dog and Taco Bell is horse meat. It's not real meat.
Oh, it's legit real meat.
No, it's horse, dude. It's not good.
We are doing a taste test.
Whether you go to Hazelwood or Taco Bell, you're going to Taco Bell?
Hazelwood
has... That's just white trash Mexican.
Okay, I will give the chicken meatball thing at Hazelwood a 5-star. They're really good.
You are no longer able to chime in when we talk about food.
You might have to muzzle me, but
I'm gonna make a note here. Dave is sports and current events only. His food numbers won't matter. That's hardcore. Big time. Good stuff, though.
I came out of the closet. There you go.
I would have rather heard you were gay. Hey, listen to that.
We would have talked less about it.
Yeah, exactly. We would have just let it slide. Now we're going to have to do a follow-up, all that shit. I think, speaking of which, I had a motorcycler come up next to me, and they pull up next to you, and the radio is just blaring. Do you do that, Dave?
Mm-mm.
Dave's got a motorcycle with a radio.
No, mine has a... volume attenuator on it, so when I slow down and the RPMs on the motorcycle go down, so the motorcycle's not as loud, my volume comes down.
Wow.
Whoa. Look at the big wheels on Dave.
It's nice because I hate when people...
It's an intimulator.
Well, when people pull up next to you in a car and it's blasting, it sucks. Think about a motorcycle. There's nothing around you. It's annoying.
I don't like it.
So I don't like to do that to people.
Like it. I noticed that happened to me the other day, and I'm just like, ugh, I can't do it. Can't do it. Hey, the wife and I went out on another adventure the other night. We went to, I think it was a 2 or 3 restaurant run, but we went over to that art garden in by the Walker. I don't even know what it's called.
The cherry thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Walked around there a little bit. That's actually really quite nice. Have you gone to the art galleries? Have you ever gone to the Walker or the art? You just walk around and look at the art?
Oh, absolutely. I'm actually a fan of it.
Do you understand it? Like, some of it you look at and you're like, that's just a rock.
Yeah.
That's just a rock. Like,
I'd say 95% of it is just terrible.
But it kind of makes you feel like you can see why people use drugs. Like, like, are you really telling me that?
That's why I'm there.
You spent 8 years working on this piece, and this is what we have. Like this, I don't know, 8 years is the number I threw out. A lot of people would say, gosh, that's just weird, but it's art. Like some of them over there, like the big blue rooster or the, there was one cool that I just posted that was like, it's like a mirrored wall or something. That's like a, I don't know. It was cool to see, but there was these two dudes on, I think you can actually buy drugs while you're there. Because there were these two guys on the bird scooters, you know, just flying around it, and they had backpacks on. And they looked like they had a lot of wind in their eyes, if you know what I mean.
Oh, yeah.
And they just kept circling. And for some reason, on this particular occasion, people kept looking at me. And I look at the wife. I'm like, do I have something on my face? Am I got bad hair? Why? What's going on? But, yeah, these guys just kept circling. And the one had a backpack on. I'm like, I think they're like drug dealers. Like,
they can sniff out the sober people.
Is that right. What it is?
Yeah.
I should have said, you guys need a ride or something? You want me to drive your scooter somewhere?
You definitely have to do acid to get the blue chicken. Because the blue chicken means, what is the blue chicken?
I don't know. We'll have to Google that shit.
I get the cherry and the spoon. I mean, that's kind of an iconic thing in Minnesota. The spoon
sprays water now.
Yeah, and that's an iconic thing. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, absolutely. For Minneapolis, it is. Absolutely. Well, yeah.
But it was cool because it was like, I felt safe. I felt like, yeah, this isn't, you know, and it's uptown. It's not like it's the hood. But yeah, it was a pretty neat little experience.
When I go to the Walker, I cannot describe it. I generally think most everything in there is not art, but at the same time, I get a feeling like, I don't know. I can't describe it. I actually enjoy going there.
Wow. For what it's worth. Hmm. So Eric's an art buff and Dave likes Taco Bell.
Although
got some diversity on the show.
Have you been to Walker?
Not in a long time. I like to go when they do the crazy ads.
You know, like there's two things. The last British one was there. Ads. Not a great use of square footage.
Oh, really?
I mean, you'll walk into a room that is a solid 50 feet by 75 feet, and there'll be like two things in it. It's really...
Well, they were probably expecting a line, and they wanted...
Well, that's part of the art. Like, I don't know. It's really odd. Mm-hmm. But the missus and I were... This was a while ago. We were there just kind of wandering around, and we popped into a little room. And they have, like, art is not just on the walls, man. They had, like, an artist made a film, I want to say, real loosely.
Oh, wow.
And it's just in a room, like a little, I don't know, size of an average living room, playing dark. People okay. Hanging around.
Really?
Really weird. Yeah, and I'm talking weird movie.
Was it smoky in there?
This is above Smokey.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa.
This is referencing Dave's Black Diamond.
Yes. In the chicken.
Right on, man.
Yeah, it was different.
Speaking of which, they just had...
We split and hit Taco Bell.
Right, exactly.
That's entirely possible from that location to get to a Taco Bell rapido. Did they serve booze there?
At Taco Bell?
No, at the Walker. I don't know. They don't serve it at Taco Bell because you're only supposed to be 12 when you eat there.
Dave just got a little chubby.
Wait a minute. Which Taco Bell are you talking about?
Hey, now. No.
Do you want to know where the closest Taco Bell is to the art center? I'll tell you.
No.
Just down no, Franklin.
Darren, there is an absolute wine, for sure, wine presence.
Oh, so you're going to the Taco Walker. Bell in the hood?
Well, like, you can if you have to.
Oh, my gosh. Would you go? Okay. Pop question.
Go.
Would you go to the Popeyes on Hennepin? It's on Lake. Lake and down there.
I know exactly where
Lake
it is.
Lake and like 35.
And yes, I would.
You would? Would you eat in the restaurant?
No. That would be a to-go situation.
You would eat at a Popeyes though?
What is Popeyes?
I have ate at Popeyes.
Oh my God.
Sometimes when I go get my hair cut down there at Floyd's.
What?
At Floyd's.
You go down there to get that? Cut?
Yeah.
You go that far for that?
The Mohawk, when I get the sides
cut,
I
could do that with a Floyd's. I could do that with a suck cut.
And Floyd's is down kind of in uptown on Lake Street. And sometimes I'll just keep going down to Popeyes, because Popeyes has good chicken. You've seen the commercials.
Most folks' idea of a $5 deal is not a meal, honey.
We got this here giant burger and a soda.
That's not a meal. This is a meal. Come and get it while it lasts, because it will not last long. That's a big box.
Oh, I have. Oh,
no, chicken from Popeyes.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's the lady, right?
Right,
the lady,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
I'm not. Yeah, this is where we end the conversation.
You wouldn't eat there or what?
Me?
Yeah.
Would not.
Yeah, oh, hell no. Hell no.
You guys got to open.
He won't even go to a fast food restaurant.
You guys are
hoity-toity. What?
Yeah, no. It's got to be desperate for me to go to fast food.
I can go right from Yumi Sushi to Taco Bell to Manny's. It don't matter.
Wow.
I don't discriminate.
Your wife must be so proud.
If it's good, I eat it.
If it's good, I eat it. Put that on a shirt.
Right. Ooh, right. I'll pencil that down. Oops.
That is actually a good DK t-shirt.
yeah, right.
I'm going to need royalties for that.
I'll give you half of everything I get.
All right, deal.
So what else we got going on, boys? I had a whole pile. Hey, Eric, were you down at the Gay Pride Parade?
Yeah.
What'd you say? If it's good, I'll eat it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You were down there?
No.
Did you have your own float?
We were gone for the weekend again.
Oh, yeah, because of the Pride Parade?
No.
Wanted to avoid the congestion downtown?
No, more baseball.
Oh, of course. Oh, God, I don't miss that. I don't miss that at all. Although, you know what? These soccer people, whoo.
I think I texted you this, Darren, at some point, but I did not know when signing up that there would be 26 games in the month of June played.
Stop whining.
Isn't that brutal?
That's a lot, man.
That's the way it should be. That's the way it should be. If you're going to get good, you can't practice piano once a week and expect to be Mozart.
Wow. Yeah, well,
I don't think they're teaching Mozart, but you know what I mean. You know what I mean.
Yeah, I like it. It's just a lot. I mean, it's been all work and all baseball for a month.
Yeah, get used to it. You got about 10 years left. Dave and I are not. We're headed to more relaxing times.
Hey, you're headed to AZ to party.
Right. Hey, so you just brought up kickball, soccer. So this lady that says that, I don't even remember her name. She plays for the women's team that says she's not going to the effing White House.
Oh, really?
Are we all going to lose sleep over
there's
that?
There's one of those every other week from some team.
No shit.
That's going to be big in the soccer community, though.
She's a kickball player. Do we really give a shit if she goes to the White House?
Throwing stones. You know what? My 13-year-old plays at a very competitive level. And these parents are special. We played a game last Saturday in a tournament championship game, which took the W. I just want everybody to know that. And these parents, like a lot of women, there weren't like a lot of dads. Like it was all women. I'm not saying, I'm just saying. But what? The one mom must have been the goalie's moms. I'm not sure. But like it's a more physical sport at 13, more physical. And and they're just yelling, don't touch him. Don't touch him. You can't touch him. And I'm like, huh, take a pill. What? I mean, these people were into it. Like yelling, and it's like, why do you have him out there? Bring him back home, put him back in the bubble wrap, and leave him in the corner, because evidently he can't be outside and move into society.
See, I'm not for that at all. If you're a parent at a game, all you should be yelling is heavily overused sports cliches.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yep. Oh, and the worst part of it, too, is... Oh, great job, Tommy. Really great job. And it's like, no, that was a shitty job. A great job would have scored.
Tommy sucked right
there.
Yeah,
Tommy shit the bed. They just had a thing on Instagram of this announcer who was announcing that way.
Yeah, everybody gets a fucking trophy.
That was awesome.
Exactly.
Everybody gets a trophy.
Darren, you are 100% right. Doing all these games, there are people who constantly will yell. Okay, there's a pitch made by a 10-year-old. And it happens to be on the opposite side of the batter that it's supposed to be, right?
We call that inside outside.
What do you think when that happens?
Very common in West Tonka.
Right.
When that happens, what do you think one parent says?
Oh, great try. Great try.
No, good eye.
Good eye.
To the batter?
To the batter.
Did you immediately go over there and throttle him in the head?
Oh, like,
good eye.
Maybe good reflexes for getting out of the way.
Yeah, but get the fuck out of the way.
If you have a true inside outside though, you can't get out of the way because you'll actually get into the pitch.
You have to go forward.
Yeah, you have to go forward. Right. Very difficult to teach a 10-year-old. So I might have to side with the parent on this one.
Right.
Good eye. Way to not move. Yeah, way to not move. Shell shock.
A lot of times that inside outside scares them so much it turns into a foul because it hits their bat when they're trying to get out of the way.
Right.
Hey, great job. Keep trying. Keep going. Ooh. And it's worse than soccer because, you know, soccer is one of those games where if you don't play at a very competitive level, anybody can play. I mean, it is glorified kickball. But when you get up to the higher level, and if somebody says that they don't get soccer and soccer's a kickball, that just means you don't understand the game. And this is a cliche. I know it is. It sounds like something you've heard before, but I've seen some people who can play soccer, and it's impressive. The footwork, the dramatics when they want to get a breather and they fake being hurt. I mean, not just anyone can do this at this level. It's awesome.
It's extreme athletic prowess and vision. I mean, you got to know where the field it looked down while you're ball handling. Oof.
The best part about soccer is the fake injuries.
We call that soccer hurt.
Soccer hurt, man.
Is he really hurt? Just soccer hurt.
Yeah, there's not a lot of.
And 95%.
What age does that start? What age does soccer hurt start?
I think about 4 weeks old. It's a highly learned trait. As soon as they can get on the field, they can be soccer hurt, and they will. The good soccer players learn it early because there's a lot of advantages to being soccer hurt if nobody knows that you're soccer hurt. But once they figure it out, you know, then the
jig is up.
Yeah. Yeah. And some of the kids are super dramatic, but it's like, whatever. It is what it is. It's fun. My kid, we won the tournament last weekend. Just thanks for asking.
Nice.
Yeah. I took home the hardware, but
a bomber.
Is there a penalty for two faking soccer hurt? Like if you,
if the coach has to come on the field, then you have to leave the field. Like, if you fake it just long enough where the coach starts to come up, then you pop up, nothing. But they don't
shake your leg a little bit.
But they don't stop the clock. The clock keeps running. So you want to get soccer hurt there, buddy, on the losing team? Get soccer hurt. I don't care. We got more points than you do. You understand how the winning thing works?
Oh, I did not know that. So the time keeps going.
When you get to the professional level, they'll add time at the end of the game for time that got sucked up by people because they do it at professional level too. They get soccer hurt. So then you'll have a 90-minute game with like a 6-minute kicker. You know, just that little bonus time, and they don't tell you how long it is. They just tell you got bonus time now.
Oh, so it's like it's a little on the edge of your seat.
We're just kicking the ball around here on the soccer corner today and trying to get a little more in depth on how that all works because it's a fun little game. Yeah, no, it's cool. It's high energy.
He's having fun with it. Good for him.
Yeah.
Good for you.
It's a lot more fun to watch than baseball.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to welcome you to the DK Project Soccer Hour.
This is the Soccer Hour where we'll be talking about balls, kicking balls.
This is the DK portion of the BBC.
Right, exactly.
Not using your hands to get to your balls because that's not easy to do.
Right.
We can totally
tune in later for a completely different ball handling topic.
Yeah. In our after hours show, we'll discuss ball handling. After you've been to Taco Bell,
the headbanger balls.
How to keep from getting New York balls It's time to hear from one of our favorite sponsors, the Lost Lake Creamery, located at 5575 Shoreline Drive in Mound, Minnesota, on the north end of Lake Minnetonka. Just go to Cook's Bay, find Lost Lake Channel on the north end, and follow it all the way to the ice cream parlor. Or if you're out on the bike or the rollerblades, take the Dakota Trail to the Lost Lake Creamery. Stop in, tell them you heard it on the project, the Lost Lake Creamery, old-fashioned ice cream. And we're back. So anywho, we got some new sponsors coming on board. Things are turning around here at the project. Working on a couple new things. Dave and I were brainstorming earlier today for some new ideas. People have been chiming in. Been getting a lot of feedback. The Mark Norman show was strong.
Real strong.
Brent Gill's show was strong. Actually, Mark Norman's going to be coming to town here in October, so we will probably circle back with him then. Ooh, speaking of which, you know what I got this week on my Facebook? I got a Facebook message. I don't ever check it. I don't even know that it exists. The morning show I used to do last fall, the guy that I did it with who owns the station and was my counterpart,
yeah,
he said, hey, how about a reboot? What do you think? I'm like, I don't know. I just don't think I have the time. But it was fun, man. We had a lot of fun on that show getting going. But
is that where you landed?
What does that mean? Oh, how I responded?
Is that the reboot?
You know, I just said I love the idea, but I don't think I have the time. It's crazy. And plus, I'm focusing on the podcast right now. So I maybe he wants to put our show on his station. That would be cool. Shout out! But
can you do that?
Really cool.
You can do whatever we want, man. This is America. No. This is America. Well,
but his show is on the radio with FCC rules. So I mean, can you?
No. He's on the internet.
Oh, he is. Okay.
It's an internet based show, so you can do what you want. I went through my shtick too fast today. That's all right. Anyway.
Yeah, you were rolling.
Yeah, I know. That's why I was expecting a little bit out of you two. Hey, we got a new segment we're working in here that I almost forgot about, David.
Ooh.
Dave's been watching a little bit of comedy on TV. He's doing the YouTube Comedy Corner. Everything's in a corner on the podcast. But on today's Dave's Comedy Corner, he watched a little Eddie Murphy Delirious.
Oh, classic.
It was.
So good.
It was you tell it, Dave. This is your corner, man. You got the rope. You got the reins.
It was when Eddie was talking about having don't go to cookouts. Everybody comes to the cookout, right? Okay. And then Gus comes and he starts trying to run the fire. And like, this is literally how my family works in a lot of ways too. Like, we always argue about who's going to run the barbecue. The fire's too damn big. Everything's burnt.
Oh, really?
Yes. So this is why I'm laughing about it. My Uncle Donnie gets in there and then my Uncle Terry meanders over there.
Goonie goo goo.
Yeah. And everybody gets involved. But when I can't even think about it without laughing when he goes to Gus, he goes, Gus, we're cooking hamburgers and Franks here. We're not cooking motherfucking brontosaurus burgers.
You know, I mean,
that's how the fires at my place go. They're just way too many coals.
That was such a legendary show. I can't even tell you. But you know what I've noticed is that I had a little run-in with the old varsity baseball coach. And when I tell people about it, I reference the section of that show where he talks about the dude at the candy counter at the movies. And he's like, give me some of them Jujubes, give me some of them Thin Mints.
Yeah,
And the Mooley here is going to pay for my candy.
Right.
And he goes, what'd you say, little man? He goes, you heard me, pay for my fucking candy. And he goes, oh, you just saw Rocky. I reference that when I'm telling these people about this little varsity coach talking smack to me. And I'm thinking, oh, you just saw Rocky, little man. I think it's great. You're thinking you're tough. It was pretty funny, but that...
So cute.
That thing, if people haven't seen it, it is so worth watching. And it's very current. I mean, like, all of it is still truly funny today. Do you think you could get away with that today, though? No. He's got a lot of racial humor in there.
Some of it. I don't think you can get with get away with like some of the AIDS shit he does and like some of the stuff. But the other part on that, I don't know what happens next. You just stick your dick in and explode.
I'm gonna
or the you, the doctor, you have AIDS. I'm not a homosexual.
You're not a homosexual.
Sure you're not.
You know what, though? I think the best part of that, one of Eddie Murphy's strong suits is when he tries to talk, or he talks like a white person.
Yes.
So he'll go through a whole thing, and it makes it that much stronger. It is funny, but boy, he has fallen off the face of the earth.
Yeah.
I was just going to ask, because Delirious and Raw were like groundbreaking for stand-up comedy.
Right. Yeah.
And then he hit movies and then got weird and then nothing.
Well, right. He ran into that tranny or something, didn't he?
Yeah.
I mean, what was the last real movie you did? Dr. Dolittle or some shit?
Yeah.
No, I think it was
the... Well, and he had that song that he did.
He did all those dumb movies where he was like nine different characters.
Oh, he did do that.
And then he did?
Yeah.
Oh, don't like that.
Sexual Chocolate.
Yeah.
That was a classic.
Yeah. Yeah, he did some dumbass movie with De Niro. And I think that one of those is the last movie he's done. It was a horrible movie.
What?
Yes. He did some cop movie with De Niro.
Really?
Yes.
I don't know.
And it was not good.
That's a deep cut.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have to Google that. I think I was referencing that chart topper he had out there. My girl likes to party all the time.
Party all the time.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, that was a classic. But he has fallen off face. I don't know that he's doing anything.
I'd like to see him come back.
I'd like to see him do some stand-up.
That's what I mean.
But he's got to be pushing 60, right?
All of that, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, for sure, yeah.
Ooh.
But if he was tranny...
He'll be back.
Yeah, but if he was with a tranny and shit, think of how much awesome new material he has.
Yeah.
Well, just think about how much that would be so in right now. Like, it wouldn't be a big deal. He could go back to tranny and... Because it's okay.
You're totally right. Like, it was such a career ender, 15 years ago, whenever it was.
Right.
And now, actually, he kind of got away with it, didn't he? Like,
well, except for the ending of his career part.
Well, I think those were some choices that he made. I don't think it was a career. I don't think it was the tranny. I think it was some of the movies he picked. Eddie Murphy's 58.
Oh, 58.
Yeah. Kissing 60.
58 TV back. Show.
Well, let's hope he does some stand-up.
He was only on Saturday Night Live for like a year, wasn't he?
I think it was more than that, wasn't it?
Two or three, I think.
I don't know.
Regardless, next week, if you guys like this segment, I'll come back with another comedian of the past that we can remember some fun shit about.
A little Sam Kinison or something?
Well, you can't give me the ideas or we'll give the people the ideas. Do you want to steal the show, Eric?
Well, it's definitely not.
Stop stepping on Dave's toes.
Well, it's definitely not going to be him.
Well, it's not.
It could be.
It's not Eric's Comedy Corner. It's Dave's.
You're right, Dave. I'm sorry.
No, and you know what? Sam Kinison would be a fucking...
Although I stole the Eating with Eric segment today.
Sam Kinison would be an awesome one. And Brent Gill brought him up.
He did?
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, of course he did.
In your interview?
Yeah.
I was working on show prep. I missed that part.
Let's hope Murphy doesn't go down Cosby Row, if you know what I mean.
Let's
get back to the stand up.
Well, I don't think you choose to go down that road. I think that's in you. That's bred in you. Speaking of which, there's been a lot of talk lately about O.J. Simpson now on Twitter. And they were talking today on Tom and Christina's show about how he could people are so into that. Like, who would follow that piece of shit? Like,
no.
And actually, Tom Bernard brought it up on the morning show the other day. He goes, Chris Rock had a really funny bit about it. He goes, if O.J. Simpson wasn't a football player and an actor and a Hall of Famer, and he was like a bus driver, he would just be O.J. the murdering bus driver. Where since he's a celebrity, it's like just rolls on. But they were talking about on Tom and Christina's show today about how, you know, what kind of knife sponsorship he could get.
Oh my God.
Oh,
is that greasy or what?
I'm like, that's bad.
But how are they, all the money that he gets goes to them. The only thing they can't take is his NFL pension.
Do you think he ever comes clean?
Why wouldn't you at this point?
Well, you can't get double jeopardy. Right. You can't get retried.
Why wouldn't you just come out? We just came up on he did all this on the anniversary of the car chase, which we That's talked right. about. Wouldn't we talk about that the other day, didn't we? Yeah. But I think the fact that he's out there yapping, because his big thing on this little Twitter video, which I saw in the news, I don't follow the clown, but was, you know, everybody's been talking about me for so long. Now I'll get an opportunity to talk back and give my opinions on things. So
can't wait.
Yeah, it could be quite the little experiment in social media.
That's just another reason to hate Twitter.
God, right.
I don't know where you guys land on Twitter, but not a fan.
Well, as something that drives a lot of listeners to the podcast, I'm not going to share your view. I'm going to go ahead and say I love Twitter.
Oh, that's fine.
I don't understand it, but I'm trying to use it. I'm trying.
What I don't understand is how long can it go on without being profitable? That's a new business thing that I don't get.
What do you mean? You're talking about the podcast again?
No. You mean about ship making being worth billions of dollars and not making a dollar?
You know, like Uber and Twitter and what's the other one? Big one. How do they lose like hundreds of millions a year.
Right.
Really?
But they're worth billions.
We're in over DK's head here.
Well,
time to wrap her up.
Well, with that,
I got to get to a Taco Bell directly. Well, and that could be some food for another show. We just don't have the time today to break down all the errs in the social world that are making money or not making money. So we'll table that one for today, but we'll swing it back around next week on another Thursday adventure. So everybody tune in, tell all your friends, subscribe, give us a good review. Until then, later, boys.
Later.
Ciao.
That's it. That's the end.
That's a wrap.
Read the shtick.
That's a wrap for today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and tell all your friends. If you'd like to reach out, you can use the studio line at 612-504-6500 or by email, thedkprojectpodcast@gmail.com. And of course, there's always social media at the DK Project Podcast. Thanks for tuning in.